Okay, let's consider the consequences and significance of the French and Indian War. To begin with, the top five consequences would be: number one, the cost of the war created a significant financial burden on England, about £130 million in fact. So it was as a result of this that a series of taxes started to be levied on the colonies in an attempt to recoup some of this money. Number two, the war led to the passing of the Proclamation Act of 1763, and this act sought to limit any colonial settlement west of the Appalachian Mountains in order to try and reduce the risk of any further costly wars, especially with the Native Americans. Number three, the British attempt to limit Western expansion by colonists and any inadvertent provocation of a major Indian war further angered some of the American colonists who had either already eyed land west of the Appalachian Mountains to occupy it in the future or had in fact begun to mark it out for their possession. These disputes ultimately spurred colonial response in a rebellion rather in response to what historians have labelled the end of salutary neglect. Number four. The French and Indian War also provided opportunities for some colonists to gain important military experience that they would draw upon during the War of Independence. And a prime example of this is George Washington, who himself gained valuable military skills during the war, including the development of tactical, strategic, and logistical experience within the military context. Washington also developed important political skills in his dealings with the British military and government figures. While Washington's military exploits included some notable failures, it was the French and Indian War that provided him with the opportunity to develop his military reputation in the colonies to the extent that he became a natural choice as the commander-in-chief of the Continental Army when war finally broke out. Number five, the Treaty of Paris of 1763 brought an official end to the Seven Years' War and also saw the British capture further territory from the French in North America, this signalling the start of domination of the British as an imperial power.